Welcome back to Sports Federation TV, the show where we chat about sport, brought to you by the Western Cape Provincial Sport Confederation. As you know, one of the codes of sport that are members of SASCOC is badminton. Mr. Richard Buckley?
Yes.
Mr. Badminton, as some people will like to think or call you.
Call me, yeah.
Are you?
I'm good, thank you.
Good,
thanks,
good.
Thanks for having us, yeah.
Merril, Buckley, are you well?
Hello, good, thanks. Nice to be here.
Good, good, good. We have a bit of a family affair going on here. This young man, and I say young, in his 60th year.
Nobody knew that.
Nobody knew that. Now everybody knows Richard. You've played in literally almost every tournament this past year that you were allowed to play.
Yeah.
Was it because they were desperate or what was the... Or you're just that good?
No, good. You know, you don't have to be good to play, unless you're me. But no, I just had the opportunity. They needed players, and I qualified to play, so I played.
So, I mean, you've played in how many tournaments this year?
Well, I played three in Gauteng, one in East London, one in Cape Town, and I think there was one in Durban.
Sure, it's a tough life, eh? When you're retired and you do badminton as all you do all day.
I know, it's hard getting onto that court, man.
How did you start in this? In badminton?
In badminton, just played at... we started off when I was a kid in community centers. We used to have all different sports, with table tennis, badminton and whatever. And I was actually a table tennis player. But because we were in the community center, my brothers used to come later in the evening. I went straight after school, so I played table tennis. When they played badminton, they needed a fourth player. Then I would stand there, just serve and duck. So that's what got me into it. And I think when I started working, I went to play for my first club. And that was a while ago.
A long time ago. It was the same kind of story, Merril. You were forced to go to badminton because your father was playing or coaching?
You know, it's the truth, Mr. Badminton. He lives and eats and breathes badminton, so there was no other option but for us to get involved.
Really?
Yeah.
He didn't give you an option?
No, not like that.
But you regret playing badminton, though?
No, I really enjoy it, actually. It's just to keep active and something I can do with my dad, and it's fun. It really is.
So you would see badminton almost as your family time rather than as a chore?
Yeah, for sure. We just get to go out on the court and just knock around and, yeah. Does do something active as opposed to sitting on the couch watching TV together.
But that doesn't negate the cleaning up and all of those things that you still have to do as part of the whole family bond.
Oh, no. Well, you can't get away from that, I guess.
How do you find being involved in badminton as opposed to, I know you're a runner as well.
Yeah.
Compare the two for me.
Badminton is really just social. It's nothing serious about it, well, for me at least. Just knocking around, like I say, something to keep us active, whereas maybe in the running I'll take it a little more seriously, try a little harder, you know, go for the races, whereas in the badminton, no events or anything like that. It's just
so you don't play league, you just use it as a recreational activity?
Just completely social, yeah.
Is that to keep this man balanced and spend some time? Is
exactly.
That the only time you're going to spend time with him?
Exactly. At least I ticked that box. So I showed up, I was there, so it's fine.
I've seen him.
Yeah, I saw him that week. It's fine.
Richard.
No, it's tough being passionate about something. Eh?
and that's what shines through. I mean, I've seen you on court, I've seen you off court. At any badminton function, everybody knows Richard. Richard this, Richard that.
Yeah. I mean, I suppose maybe it's just my big mouth only.
well, that, but also because you've been playing for 100 years.
Yeah.
You know, give us some of the highlights of your playing career.
Well. Yeah, I was never big enough to make the national team or whatever. So I took it upon myself. And I went and we got a team together and we played in the World Senior Championships in Turkey. So that was my international, 2013. Yeah. And then 2014, I went to the Senior All England. Yeah, so I am an international player.
And did you have tea when you were in England?
And scones, yeah.
Oh, and scones.
Yes.
So and I went with to Turkey.
Yeah, she was with me at Turkey. Yeah.
So she was the chaperone.
Yeah, no.
Reverse chaperone.
Yeah.
How big is badminton in Cape Town?
Cape Town, badminton is not as big as we would love it to be, but I tell you what, it's not going to die down. A lot of people say the sport is dying. It's never going to die. because of the activities. I mean, at Goodwood Club where I play, for instance, we had a situation where the hall wasn't available at all times, and we ended up with like only six people playing there because we were the only ones that wanted to stick around and play in the gaps, you know. So we lost the team and everybody said, close your club because, you know, start new. And I know if you close something, you're never going to start 100%. Again. And I started coaching the kids earlier on in the evening. And those parents are all playing now. We now got three teams. We might even look at a fourth team, and it's all family teams. I mean, the parents, the children are playing. The parents are there now. They've been given a racket. Yeah. So the club has just grown to be a family club. I mean, you played there. You saw the social bit of it. And you also saw the tense and competitiveness, yeah.
And that's what makes the sport exciting.
Yeah.
Coming back to what you say, Merril, is that I can come there as a total novice in badminton and I had a good time.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah.
You know? And Merril would beat me because she's got more experience.
Yeah.
But then,
well, I mean, there's most of the people that will beat you. But
we know that. But, you know.
No, I'm only kidding. You actually put up a good show there. So.
But then you have those competitive guys who play league.
I mean,
right up to the point where we have national and international players braced that come out of Cape Town.
Yeah.
And we have a wealth of them.
Yeah, yeah.
Which come through the badminton hands in Cape Town.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, in our first league, we've got, the ex-Olympians that, you know, they're still playing league. They're still busy active. Mm. So the competition can be exactly what you want it to be. If you just want to do social like Merril does, come in there, hit a couple of shots. If there's a bit too much sweat on the brow, then they sit down, you know. And then you get the other guys that fights to, you know. And then there's the competitiveness where you're playing up against Olympian, you know, that type of thing, ex-Olympian. So the sport is just still alive. And this is what I'm saying is that it will never die because there are always people wanting to play. And families are growing. They're deciding, they're discovering now that it is actually a family sport. So husband comes and brings the child with. So then the wife comes, and next thing you know, when I coach at schools, this is the one thing I tell the kids, don't give up the game. Because when you're 30, you're coming back. So now learn the basics, learn and stick with it, because you are going to come back. And most of the guys coming back into the game now, it's all because they started when they were at school. I mean, a new player coming in now, I last played when I was at school. I played at varsity. So that's the story you hear. So when I do my coaching, do it properly and keep the basics going so that when you do come back. The problem we had was that we started coaching very late. You can't coach a 14, 15-year-old to become a world champion. He's got to be 5, 6 years old. To start there and become a culture.
For sure.
So that they can. Because it's tough going here in South Africa. We don't have the normal tournaments that the Europeans have. They have every weekend, they have an international tournament.
What?
And they just jump on a bus there.
Yeah.
We got to take a boat or a flight or whatever to get there. You know what I mean? So we can only do one or two international tournaments per year. Whereas they have it every weekend.
And the problem is it becomes self-funded.
Exactly.
Whoever we want to send,
yes,
it becomes, you have to foot the bill to get you to the international. Badminton South Africa doesn't have the money.
No, they don't.
Netball South Africa doesn't have the money.
No, no.
Tennis South Africa don't have the money.
That's right.
And and that is our problem as South Africans. I mean, Merril, you went to Turkey. That cost you a pretty penny just to go and support your father.
Yeah. Out of my own pocket.
Out of your own pocket.
Mm.
And as a spectator, you had to pay the same amount as the player.
Exactly. Yeah.
You know, and people don't understand that component. That yes, it's all great to say we're going to represent Africa, and we strive to get there. We need to build mechanisms to be able to fund athletes
to get to
that point.
Yeah.
I mean, even the development program that Western Province Badminton runs out from Sudwater has produced lots of talent.
Yeah.
But to nurture the talent also costs money.
Money, yeah. Yeah, the thing is, and this is why I'm saying that, you know, there will always be people playing the game. Because that's what we're doing. We, like you said earlier to the soccer guys, they do the mass participation. And that's what we're there for, to get people to enjoy the game. There's going to be one or two champions out of there, and we'll send them along to the different... I mean, we've got some qualified coaches and stuff. So, you know, if you show any, then we send you on to coaching a higher degree.
Yeah.
But otherwise, there's always going to be people playing. So there's no fear that we're going to be dying.
Merril, participation in sport as a woman, how do you see that as from yourself and as a motivator to someone who doesn't play sport? What would you do? What would you say?
I think it's fantastic. You know, I often have these conversations in that I think sport is bigger than the game that you're playing. Mm. In running, for instance, my dad ran the Comrades a couple of years and I went to support. And just the energy there and to see the people support strangers and people that, you know, you don't know where they come from, what they have, but because of what they're doing, because of their participation, you want to encourage that.
Yeah.
And so I'm always encouraging in whatever way I can, participate in something. Mm. I also really believe like it's important to support your neighborhood teams. So the Goodwood Sports Clubs or whatever sport code is around me that I enjoy that I can just participate in and get involved, you know, support them, help them grow, put in money if that's what's necessary. But I think it's really important. And like, as a lady as well, because a lot of the teams the soccer guy I spoke to, the Ronaldos and the whoever's, you know, it's the men.
Yeah.
But we need female role models as well. So nurture them now where they are in the clubs that they are and let us get there if there aren't any.
But you raise a valid point is that we don't showcase the women in sport.
Mm.
We don't have them as role models.
Mm. 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 So very few. They are, but not as it's not your go-to.
Exactly. Mm. Serena will look up to Desiree, but there's nothing in between.
Mm. Yeah.
Who's the woman in badminton? Yeah. Jade was there.
Yeah.
Jade has now left South Africa. Mm. Who's the next badminton champion in terms of from a female perspective that the next junior can aspire to?
Exactly.
You know.
Yeah.
And we need to be showcasing that on social media.
Yeah.
Definitely.
In terms of growth of the social component, what could we do different in a sports space? You speak about a general sports space.
Mm. I don't know. Encourage more. You know, get your numbers. Some people are afraid of competition as well. They're too scared to even go for league because it's, you know, it's the competitive space. Mm. It's not for me. But encourage more of that. I don't know, anything.
Yeah, no, it's totally about participation. Mm. Go in there, you go your level.
Mm.
Don't look at somebody else, go your level, because everybody's aspire to be different. You know what I mean? So I want to be a champion, so I'm going to go in there with serious stuff.
Yeah.
I just want to, you know, I've got a few hours in a week. I just want to go knock around.
Mm.
That is okay. Everything is okay. Mm. It's all depending on you. And we as administrators, as clubs, we must invite that. In the past, some of the clubs were very strict. Oh, they used to handpick players, and then your club is too full and can't handle it. No, we must encourage everybody to play. And it, you will find that mass participation is very important, because without the mass, you won't pick up that high performance 100%. Athlete. You won't pick up that good boy.
So. If I want to play badminton, I come down to Goodwood on a what day?
Tuesday and a Thursday evening from about 6:37, and we play till you're tired. I know you get tired about opus 8, but we stick around till about opus 10, 11-ish, whatever. Yeah.
It's called unconditioned.
Yeah.
Thank you very much.
Yes.
For all the work that you guys do in Goodwood, but also that there are other clubs in Cape Town where badminton is alive and well. John Tyers in Kenilworth. I know there's a club in Brackenfell.
Yeah, Edgemead.
Edgemead.
There's one in Stirkland. Yeah. And what can I say about what we're showcasing on the
Definitely.
18th? On the 18th, we've actually got a badminton day at Canal Walk and the food court, well, next to the food court, center court there. We'll have from 9 till 4. We'll have different clubs being represented there. So if you want to come and see what the game is all about, talk to somebody about badminton. We'll have all our different clubs members there. So you can, wherever side you are of Cape Town, there'll be somebody that can tell you how to join and where to join and whatever. Otherwise, if you're lost about not knowing where to come, come to Goodwood Badminton. I'll be there.
That's a good or bad thing. We'll leave it there. Richard and Merril, thank you very much.
Thank you.
See you on the 18th at Canal Walk.
Canal Walk, yes.
Let's take an ad break. We'll be right back.